Okay, I need your attention. The tech regulations are changing. There's a risk some of our hard work will be undone, so we need to mitigate it. As soon as you can, I want you to look at the developments we have and tell us what areas you want to invest in protecting.
Now, today is a big episode, guys. I'm not gonna lie. A lot is happening and changes are gonna take place. First of all, the regulation change has been confirmed. Chassis and durability will be at risk, so we need to try to work to protect those departments. Now, this weekend, we're at the Mexican Grand Prix. The weather forecast is dry, and not just that, history has been made. This race, the final upgrades of the season went onto the car, and we are now the third best team on the grid. So, very happy about that. History in the making, the highest we've ever been in terms of outright performance, and I'm very happy about that. We've worked so hard to get to this point, and I'm proud, but it's not over yet. Now, season 3 in many ways starts right now, and as you can see on screen, pause it if you need more time to digest this, but basically we have activated the sliders, and long story short, we're making it a lot harder for ourselves from this point on, because we've already reached the top 3. We're kind of, you know, reaching the top. There's not many upgrades left, so now is a good time to complicate things. We've got a good, you know, baseline in the team, we've got a good teammate, and now is when we've got to try and fight even harder for those final upgrades and those R&D points. So that is going to come into effect this weekend. So from this point on, things are going to be different in terms of how things work. So we jumped to practice and we had a pretty good session, but you can see instead of getting 600 points, we've only got 450. So at the bottom of the screen, just slightly to the left, 450 out of 450, that's the maximum now we can get in practice. And I'm guessing that's going to have a knock-on effect in qualifying and the race as well. So yeah, pretty much, guys. It's going to be very exciting, the end of season 2 and also the start of season 3. If you guys are excited, then drop a like and subscribe. And with that, we can now move into qualifying number 1. Now, I'm never going to cap. This was one of my scruffiest qualifying sessions I think I've ever had. So you joined me midway through my first lap in qualifying 1, and it was actually a really good lap, but I invalidated on the exit of the S section, so I quickly pulled over, turned the ERS off, and I'm just going to quickly cool off my tyres and go for a second push lap. Now, on my second lap, we actually got through the S section this time, which is great. So this time, we're going to try and finish the lap about, you know, on target right now for a top 5, give or take. It all depends on the final sector as we head through the stadium. But then through here, I just straight lined that left-hand kink a little bit too much, cutting the corner and putting an end to my lap. So across the line, it would have been an 11.5, but it's not going to count. So I knew we had pace, so I went back out again at the end of Q1, and I went out on the exact same set of soft tyres that I've already done 2 laps on, because I knew I had the pace and I didn't want to burn another fresh set. And you can see on the delta, I'm half a second down compared to the 11.5 that we've done before, therefore setting a 1.11.9. We only go P13, which is not great, and I was a little bit concerned, but luckily the lap was enough and we got through. If we'd done the 11.5, we would have been in the top 6. So it just goes to show the pace is there, and Rosberg also in the top 8. So things are looking pretty decent. But that was a pretty scruffy Q1 session. Now, Q2, we're going to try our luck on the medium tyre. Probably not going to work. The medium's quite slow around here, but still, I thought we'd give it a shot, and that way we can save a set of softs, potentially for Q3, if it works out and we go through. Now, the first lap was a 112.9, which is a long way off the pace. So I quickly realized, all right, soft tires, we're going to need those on the car. And you can see we've got a much better lap time under our belt currently as we head into the S section. But again, I just straightened the wheel up a bit too early and make another stupid mistake and get a really silly track limits warning. So again, I'm going to turn the ERS off and coast the car through the final sector, and we've got 30 seconds to go, so we need this next lap to get into Q3. So the pressure is on, and we're going to stay on board here for the full lap at the circuit of Mexico. So here we go. We're going to set it up, ERS back to hot lap mode. We've given the tires a chance to cool off a little bit. They'll cool off a bit more on this main pit stretch, which is of course super super long. And here we go then, we're going to try one more time. Currently P16, we need to improve, and we know we've got the pace. So down towards turn 1, spot the braking, approximately at the 50 meters, maybe 60 meters, you want to break down to fourth, possibly third gear. Turn two and turn three, very important to take a lot of inside curb, which I don't really do that well. DRS open on the exit as we run down to turn four. And here again, you want to spot the 100 meters as your reference under braking. Currently a 10th up on Lance Stroll in P12. Flick it left, flick it right, then down to the hairpin, double apex right. Important here to pick up the second apex and use all the runoff curb to really help make that exit. Then into the S section again. Let's see if this time we keep it clean. You can see well within bounds this time, keeping it pretty safe and not wanting to invalidate as we then open DRS on the back straight. So far, 2/10 up on Gasly in P12 as we head into sector 3. Tidy through the right-hander, now into the hairpin in the baseball stadium. Steady does it. A little bit too slow through there, taking a bit too much inside curb and actually losing a bit of momentum. And then the final corner, easy on the throttle, keep it tight to the right, and across the line we go, and we do set a good valid lap time. Is it enough to get into Q3? The answer is yes. P9 with a 1:11.5, so we pretty much match our Q1 time that we would have set without the invalidation. Nico Rosberg 11:4, and also into Q3, and for the first time this season, I believe, both cars into Q3, which is awesome. So great to see Rosberg up there as we head into Q3. Now this was a pretty good session for us. We had two fresh sets of soft compound tyres, but my first run got a bit out of shape in the S section. I started to overheat the rears. I was overdriving, pushing too much, and I completely spun off the track in the S section. So again, that part of the track giving us more problems. And pretty much what I did was I actually cooled my tyres off. I had a very, very slow sector 3, and I committed to another push lap on these tyres, and I was able to actually get a pretty good lap out of them. As we crossed the line, we set a 1:11.3, I believe, and a very strong lap, best lap of the weekend so far. Even with the spin on those tyres, we find a good lap. But now, the main event, the final lap in qualifying. Can we pull something out of the bag? Let's find out. Enjoy the lap, guys, and hopefully it's a good one.
Seconds left in the session.
And there we go, across the line. It's a big lap, it's an improvement, and I believe a 1:11.1, which is our best lap of the weekend. We saved it right to the death, but we done it. We pulled it out of the bag, and we're going to finish P5 in Q3, Rosberg P8, and a good qualifying session from us. Happy with that. And it was super, super scruffy, but somehow we've managed to salvage something and get a top five. So I'm really just, you know, satisfied that we managed to turn that around after so many laps in qualifying, so many messy, invalidated laps. You know, when it mattered, we delivered. And Rosberg in the top eight as well. So really good qualifying. But we're now going to move into the race, and we're going to see if we can make it a double points finish for both cars here at Mexico.
Here we go then, it's time to race in Mexico City, a place which gave Honda their first ever victory back in 1965. American Richie Ginther won from third on the grid. And what of the Honda-powered cars this year? Well, Red Bull have been going strong here in recent seasons, so can they keep that record going today? The Autódromo Hermanos Rodríguez, 2.6 miles of track that allows drivers to take full advantage of their cars, reaching speeds in excess of 220 miles per hour, and providing lots of opportunities for overtaking. The circuit features 17 corners, 10 to the right and the remaining 7 going to the left. And as always, a man with plenty of racing experience joins me in the commentary box. Today it's Anthony Davidson. Tell me, Ant, you're no stranger to surviving the melee of Turn 1. So how do you keep out of trouble when there's so much going on around you?
There are three main things to worry about there, Crofty. Positioning, awareness and discipline. First, you have to put your car in a bit of space and make sure you have room to react to what the others are doing. Then you have to watch your mirrors and listen to the sounds around you to get a sense of where everyone is. And finally, just don't get too greedy. Just because a gap exists doesn't always mean you should go for it.
With the race minutes away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. Lewis Hamilton lines up on pole position and Max Verstappen lines up alongside. As we continue through the rest of the grid today, we have Bottas, Martinez, Sergio Perez and Norris, Russell, Sainz, Vettel and Lance Stroll, Ricciardo, they'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty, Raikkonen, Christian Lundgaard and Giovinazzi, Leclerc, Latifi, Nikita Mazepin and Mick Schumacher, Tsunoda, Gasly, Ocon and Nico Rosberg. And with preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track.
Now for the race, we're going to start from P4. Really, really good news heading into this. The fact we've been promoted by an extra position and we're now on the second row of the grid. The only bad news is Nico Rosberg. Unfortunately, you may have seen on the grid rundown, he has a grid penalty and he's starting from P22 and last place. So, not ideal, not what we wanted to see heading into the race, especially after such a strong qualifying from both of us. There was a real good potential for points. But hopefully Nico can still fight back. Realistically, it's going to be a bit of a tricky one because he's forced to start on the soft tire that he used in Q2, starting from last place. So it's looking a bit peak, I'm not going to lie. Anyway, P4, second row. For us, we've got two strategy options. We either one stop it, soft, medium, or we two stop it, soft, medium, soft. Usually around here, the two stop is faster than the one. So I'll make a decision around lap 10 and we'll see what we go for because, you know, we've got options to try and go for today. So we'll see how we use them. Now, for the race itself, the target for the first few laps is to just stay in P4, see if we can maybe get a place or two at the start, possibly. If not, just wait until DRS gets enabled. And then once the race opens up, we'll see if we can make things happen. Similar to Singapore and Hungary, the overcut should be quite powerful. So if we can extend our first stint a little bit, that might help us out. So let's jump into it. Let's see what happens. If you guys are excited, drop a like and let's get into the action. Okay, let's jump into it. Should be fun. Nice long run down to turn one. Anything can happen. 5 lights are on and the 5 lights are out. Ooh, good start. Oh my god, Perez off to a flyer in the other Red Bull. What a launch off the line. We're going to go to the outside here and try and get the better slipstream. Here we go. Oh my god, this is so close. Got to try and fight though and not give up easily. We've got Max to our left here. We're going to see if I can get the traction down, which we do. And I'm going to edge ahead of Verstappen, so we're going to make the move up to P4. Hamilton holds onto the race lead, which is massive for the championship. Bottas up to P2, Perez up to P3. What a start in this home Grand Prix from, I believe, P5 on the grid, maybe even P6. We've moved up to P4. Well, moved up. We've stayed P4, but we've overtaken Verstappen, technically. So don't mind that. Let's see if we can keep pace. Also trying to overheat our tyres if possible. I had a pretty miserable race in terms of track limits or qualifying, should I say, yesterday. As here comes Verstappen, he's challenging us here. Out of nowhere, Max ran the outside. Going to give him the squeeze there. He's not going to get past me in that corner. As I was saying, we had a pretty miserable qualifying in terms of track limits and struggling to have clean runs. So hopefully the race is a bit better. We ain't got to run as fast, so it should be a bit more under control as the car tries to snap on me there. So lap 2. Let's see what the straight line speed is saying. Looks like we're pretty decent so far. I'm going to use a bit of the ERS to try and stay ahead. And we need a big lap here to try and get back within a second of Perez, if we have the pace for that, of course. I don't quite have the pace right now to get within Perez's DRS. I'm actually going to let Verstappen go here. I'm going to be tactical with this, try and be smart. Realistically, there's no point in draining my battery. We'll see if Verstappen can work as that kind of go-between as Raikkonen retires from the race. Hopefully not a safety car, because that would be terrible timing for me letting Verstappen through. We're going to try and use Max to see if he can take us towards Perez. It feels like the Mercs are just a bit too quick today, so we'll focus on maybe battling for a podium, possibly. First warning for track limits on lap 5, a little bit earlier than I'd hoped for. But right now the plan is working beautifully, so Verstappen is forcing Perez to pick up his engine mode, which is good for all of us. We're going to set a personal best here. And just keeping the pace up, basically. This is working out really well for us. Lando's still holding on. He's not letting us go. But we're right in the mix here. So now Verstappen is going to go for it on Perez. This might be an opportunity for us to pass the Mexican. And potentially move back up to P4. Max runs in a bit hot into 1. We're going to see if we can get the drive out of 3 and 4. Here we go.
Nico has come into the pits. He's in the pit lane now.
Oh my god, to the outside. Bit of a moment there. Still going to get it though. Perez a bit slow to commit to that corner, so I just went up the inside. That was a very, very scruffy move though. I've dropped out of DRS range from Verstappen, which is not ideal. Don't think we're going to get it. No, I think we just dropped out there. That's a shame. And my rear's overheating. I can feel it. Okay, no, they're not. Just sliding all over the place. Never mind. Right. P4, we've got that back at least, but Verstappen has got away. Oh my god, that was a scary one. I did manage to get DRS on Verstappen though. I'm trying to push, see if I can get back within a second and work my way back in, but we are pushing flat out and that mistake is going to cost me. As I tried to get DRS here onto the pit straight, never mind. This time we've done it. We've got back within DRS range of Verstappen, so we can stop using all of our energy trying to drain it to keep up on the pit straight. We've done enough. We can relax a little bit now and try and plan out the rest of the stint before the pit stops arrive. Oh my god, that was close. Verstappen there, I think he locked up or something, but we almost ran clean into the back of him. Meanwhile, Lando and Perez are battling, so they're starting to lose a bit of time. They're now out of DRS range. Oh, okay, Verstappen pits. There we go. Hamilton in as well. Bottas stays out. Right, it's time to push. We're going to have DRS in this one, so let's give everything we've got. Currently about a tenth up on my personal best. Bottas should be pitting. Yes, he does, and we're going to join him. Easy does it. Right, so we're going to box very, very good in lap. I don't know if we'll be able to overcut Verstappen realistically, but we'll have one lap fresher tyres. Bottas has gone for softs, which means Hamilton and Verstappen probably have as well. We're going for the mediums now to get these out of the way.
Go, exit now.
3.1, it's a slow stop, but we've jumped Bottas, so Bottas must have got held.
That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops.
Okay, lovely stuff. So Bottas got held, and we've rejoined ahead of Lando, behind Verstappen, and seemingly the only person on a medium tyre. As you can hear, the dogs outside very excited about us jumping Bottas. Anyway, let's crack on. And let's push. I think Bottas, though, is going to pass us pretty quickly. I think he's going to pass me right here, so I'm never going to really fight this too hard. No point. You could see he was closing in even without DRS. I'm just going to try and follow him if I can and get DRS as Rosberg pits. Oh, here comes Lando. I thought I had DRS and Bottas, but it wasn't the case. So we're just going to let Norris drive on again, take the race in line. Just don't have the pace right now. We're going to have to suffer this a little bit. Hopefully he'll come back to us in the second half of the race. Stroll in the pit lane. Hard tyre for him, so interesting. Bit of a different strategy from Aston Martin. This is working though. I think I can keep up with Lando. He's more realistic for me in terms of pace. Hamilton fastest lap, 1:13.1. Sebastian Vettel pits. We set our personal best, 1:14.1. So that says a lot about the pace of the Mercedes here today. Got Perez behind, but kind of in a bit of a train right now behind Lando, so this is pretty decent for us. I think we can hold on to this. Okay, I think this is it. This feels like the crossover. I feel like the soft tyres are just starting to lose their edge a little bit. Now there's a lap car ahead, which we're starting to catch, which will probably give Lando DRS on the next lap, which I don't really want. So we're going to get this move done now. Let's go for it. We've got a full charge of ERS. Doesn't have to necessarily be done into turn one, but I think that's what I'm going to go for. I want the clean air. So here we go, closing in on Lando to the outside. Oh, it's a bit of a tight one, but we've made it work. thought we had it on the brakes, and Lando kind of let off the brake a bit and tried to come back at me, but we've got it done and dusted, and we're now going to get DRS. So let's try and push and see if we can actually drop Lando. Bottas and Verstappen do have a bit of a gap now, so I've made a bit of a mess of that corner there. Let's see if we have a good S section. Maybe we can try and pull away. Blue flag for Mazda spin. Luckily it gets out of the way, so we can crack on. I think he might actually hold up Lando and Perez through the S's here, so that's going to work out in our favour beautifully. And it has done. I think I've actually dropped Lando out of DRS range. Perfect. I think Perez and Lando are still battling. They've been locked in an absolute titanic battle this lap, and the gap has gone from 1 to 7 seconds. I wonder if they both got damaged battling. Hamilton and Verstappen pit though. Bottas should be in this lap, so let's see what happens. But the race has really opened up in this last couple laps. I'm going to try and keep the pace up as much as I can, but we are lacking a little bit of rhythm, to be honest. And there it is, Bottas pitting as expected. A few more laps for us though. We're going to box around lap 26, 27, so let's keep going. Second warning, I was a bit out of shape through the S's the whole way through. Just didn't quite get the car stable. And look at this, blue flag. Nico Rosberg, he's very slow on soft tyres. I'm wondering if he's got wing damage. He's already stopped twice, and I think he's going to have to stop for a third time. So Rosberg, way off the pace today in this race. I'm not sure what's happened to my teammate, but the grip penalty has screwed him over big time.
Nico has come into the pits. He's in the pit lane now.
Oh, we've got a yellow flag up ahead. Seems to have gone now. Oh no, it's still up ahead.
Caution, caution.
Someone's slowing down. I think it might be an Alpine.
Someone's come off ahead of you. There's a yellow flag ahead.
Well, they've gone down the escape road, whoever that was. It's actually Christian Lundgaard in the Williams. We're going to box this lap though for a set of soft tyres. They're not going to be fresh. It's going to be a used set, but we're going to go for it anyway. They're going to be pretty quick. And this is to try and solidify P4 in this race. I don't think we've got enough pace for a podium, unfortunately, which is a bit of a shame. I thought about staying out, but I'm losing about a second and a bit per lap to Hamilton. It's going to get worse as my tyres start to fade. So we're going to box now. Bit of a slow one. 3 seconds. Not good enough. We're going to rejoin ahead of Stroll, who's on the hard tyre, though. It's going to be close, though. But I think we should have it. Yeah, there we go. Just out ahead of Stroll. Him and Seb on the hard tyre. So P4, looking pretty decent. We started P4. If we can finish here, I'll be happy. We'll do our thing now for the final few laps. Push on, see what we have left in the tank. Realistically, I think 12 seconds to Verstappen is probably a bit too tall of a mountain to climb.
Ordered a time penalty. It'll go against our finishing time at the end of the race.
And that is not going to help. So let's just focus on clearing the 3 seconds to Stroll and bringing this one home in P4 by the looks of it. Time penalty. Not ideal. It's been a bad weekend for tracking this, I've got to say. Purple sector 3. Have we done enough for a fastest lap, maybe? That could be a cheeky little extra point. Across the line. And there we go, 12-6. Lovely. So we have got the fastest lap at least. That's something. An extra point. Let's bring it home then and secure these points. Thanks to a little bit of DRS in the middle sector, we're going to go a tenth quicker. Hopefully that's enough to lock in the fastest lap. Let's bring this one home though. I've got to say, it's been a fairly routine Grand Prix in terms of how it's gone. I've just done my thing and it worked pretty well. The confetti goes off, but look at that. The 3 second penalty in the end didn't really mean anything as we done it quite comfortably. 18 seconds clear from Ricardo. Hamilton wins as my FPS is dropping a little bit. Bottas P2, Verstappen P3, and we pick up P4 and hopefully a fastest lap.
That's the end of the race. We'll see you in Parc Fermé.
And so the celebrations begin, and well earned they are indeed. It may have looked simple at times, but as any racing driver will tell you, competing at this level, at the very top, is anything but simple. There's no catching them now then. We have a new World Drivers' Champion. Not just victory today then, but the championship as well. What a spectacular season they've had. Congratulations to the whole team. Anthony, tell me, what was it that helped them achieve this success?
I feel like consistency was probably the key today. There's being quick, and then there's being quick lap after lap after lap. If you can do that, you can capitalise on other people's errors without making many of your own. And that's an approach that can push you a long way up the field.
Mercedes are on top form once again after an excellent race weekend. It's great to see them up on that podium once again.
Well, there you have it. Lewis Hamilton is a 9-time Formula One world champion. He wins yet another championship, another feather to the cap for the champ. And Bottas pushed him all the way, but again, just couldn't quite make it happen. Lewis P1, Bottas P2, Verstappen P3. We finish in P4 with a fastest lap and a 3-second time penalty. Ricciardo P5 ahead of Stroll and Vettel. Norris, Perez and Leclerc round out the point scorers. George Russell P11 missing out on the top 10 along with Sainz, Gasly, Giovinazzi, Schumacher, Tsunoda, Latifi, Mazepin and then Rosberg, who done 4 stops this race, by the way. Not sure what happened today with Nico. Just feels like the group penalty set him back and he never really recovered. Ocon P20 also behind Rosberg on 4 stops, and then Lundgaard and Raikkonen out of the race. Now we look at the standings, of course Hamilton champion, so let's quickly confirm that really quickly. He's 95 points clear with 3 races to go, which means 75 points up for grabs. Elsewhere we are still P5, 9 points ahead of Lando, and with an outside chance of possibly snatching P4 from Ricciardo if results go our way. In the constructors, we're P5, and now the gap to Aston Martin is 9 points. It feels like it's just slightly going up. The grid penalty for Rosberg today was not ideal. I feel like he's really having to, you know, pick up all the bad things from Aaron Barnes. You know, all the worn engines and stuff from Aaron Barnes are starting to take effect, and Rosberg suffering as a consequence. So maybe next season on a clean slate could be a better chance to judge Nico in terms of outright pace. Either way, we've still got a chance. We're still in the mix, so we'll keep pushing and keep fighting. Nonetheless, guys, we're now going to move into the next race. Now, I believe it's Brazil, and then it's Australia. So, yeah, Brazil next. Hopefully, guys, look forward to that. We'll take care of the small bit of admin work we have to do in the next episode, as we're not doing upgrades anymore. If you guys enjoyed today's video, leave a like, subscribe for more daily F1 content on my channel. As always, you know, if we can try and smash 1,200 likes, that'd be awesome. And also, the red subscribe button, if you want to help me out, I appreciate it. And also, hey, listen, I haven't said this in a while, but hit the bell icon, notify when videos do go out. That really helps me out as well. As always, check out the 2 videos on screen if you have missed them. And that's it from me. I'll see you all next time. Until then, take care and adios.